So hi everyone, my name is Kylie and I'm a medical student at the University of Ottawa and I'm working with Dr. Jennifer Tsang from McMaster University. I'm excited to be talking to you about our project entitled The Motivating Factors, Barriers and Facilitators of Community Intensive Care Units Participation in COVID-19 Pandemic Research. So to give some background information on our study, over two-thirds of Canadian hospital beds are located in community hospitals. So community hospitals are those that are not associated with medical schools or academic institutions typically. And with the majority of Canadian COVID-19 patients being treated in community hospitals as well. However, only a small number of Canadian community hospitals actually participate in pandemic research, with the majority of research in this area coming from academic sites. So those that are associated with medical schools or academic institutions. So for example, in the Solidarity and REMAP-CAP trials, which were two large COVID-19 studies, community hospitals only represented about 12% and 9% of Canadian sites respectively. Therefore, community hospitals represent a major untapped resource for research participation in Canada. So if clinical trial enrollment was to be increased in community hospitals, this would lead to an overall increase in clinical trial enrollment, as well as a broader cross-section of patients. And this is important because, for example, progressive waves of COVID-19 have targeted minority groups and essential workers who may be more likely to present to community hospitals based on their location and their proximity to those hospitals. And so including them in clinical trial enrollment would provide a greater representation of the overall Canadian patient population. So recognizing this need for a broader participation in COVID-19 pandemic research and to better understand the research landscape in community hospitals in Canada, the Canadian Community Intensive Care Unit Research Network, also known as CIRNET, conducted a cross-sectional survey to explore the motivating factors, perceived barriers, and perceived facilitators of participation in COVID-19 pandemic research. So the study methodology heard over three stages: survey development and testing, survey administration, and statistical analysis. And these occurred between May and November of 2020. And we followed Karen Burns' guide for the design and conduct of self-administered surveys of clinicians. So in the survey development and testing stage, the team started with item generation, where we conducted a literature review for motivating factors, barriers, and facilitators of research participation. And these survey items were then grouped into seven domains, which then helped in the questionnaire and response formatting stage. And so the final survey included multiple question formats, and it was pre-tested and pilot tested by three critical care physicians for relevance and flow. The target population for the survey included critical care physicians, nurses, allied health professionals, research staff, and hospital administrators in community ICUs. And it was disseminated through the Canadian Critical Care Trials Group, CIRNET, and the Canadian Critical Care Society. And snowball sampling was used within the ICUs to recruit non-MD participants as well. For the statistical analysis, and one reminder, email was sent out. For the statistical analysis, data were described as mean and standard deviation for continuous variables, and continuous variables were compared using the parametric student t-test. So in total, responses were received from 73 Canadian community ICU stakeholders, representing 18 community ICUs across Canada. And the majority of respondents were physicians and nurses, as seen in figure one, with around 37% of participants in other roles. The majority of the hospitals that were surveyed were from Ontario, with some representation from Alberta and Manitoba as well. When surveying participants' previous research experience, most participants had experience caring for patients enrolled in clinical research studies, so around 64%. Followed by research experience as a trainee, so when the participants were students or residents. And interest in research was assessed on a 7-point Likert scale from not interested to very interested, as seen in figure four. And it was overall rated at 5.2 amongst the participants. So as noted, the study really wanted to explore the motivating factors, perceived barriers, and perceived facilitators of participation in COVID-19 research amongst Canadian community ICUs. And so with respect to the motivating factors for research, participants were asked to rate their level of agreement with 12 possible motivating factors on a 5-point Likert scale. And the most significant motivating factors that were outlined included research, the fact that research improves clinical care and outcomes. Research advances medical knowledge. Participation in research allows participants to stay informed about current research. Participation in research allows participants to establish collaborations with other ICUs, and the fact that research enhances professional opportunities in the hospital. So similarly, participants were asked to evaluate the potential barriers and facilitators of research involvement on a 5-point Likert scale as well. So the most significant barriers, as you can see in figure 6, were found to be a lack of startup funding for a research coordinator, as well as inadequate per patient payments to sustain a research coordinator salary. In addition, staff workload was too high due to pandemic related pressures. Community ICUs are not known or expected to do research, so issues around the identity of community hospitals versus academic hospitals. And lastly, the lack of research experience within ICUs. And the most significant facilitators were found to be a dedicated external funding to provide startup costs for research programs, and as well as sustaining ongoing costs for the research programs. Availability of an experienced research coordinator, participation in research networks that support community hospitals, and administrative support for research infrastructure as well. So to conclude and summarize on these findings, community ICUs are used to treat the majority of patients. So 75% of patients in Canada that were affected by COVID-19, however, represent a minority of participants in the clinical trials for COVID-19. So in order to improve patient outcomes and more accurately represent the Canadian ICU patient population, we must aim to increase community ICU involvement in clinical trials. And to our knowledge, this was the first study exploring the motivating factors, barriers, and facilitators of community ICU participation in pandemic research. And our cross-sectional survey-based study determined that there's in fact a moderate to high level of community ICU stakeholder interest in actually participating in research. And this interest comes from a couple different motivating factors, most commonly being the fact that participants believe that engaging in research would result in better patient care and advancement of medical knowledge, as well as improving their job satisfaction. However, as noted, there are multiple barriers identified with respect to their participation in research. So just to summarize those barriers, the most commonly endorsed barriers were a lack of financial support, absence of experienced research coordinators to start up and operationalize research programs. And so these barriers really need to be addressed in order to support the stakeholders' interest in participating in research. So in terms of funding, internal funding sources, as well as the provincial healthcare funding for research startup and ongoing costs really should be improved given the substantial evidence of improved patient outcomes in hospitals that participate in research. And finally, to address the lack of research experience, partnerships should be fostered between community and academic hospitals in order to allow for improvement in research mentorship, both at an organizational level and at an ICU research level. This has already proven to be successful with hospitals such as St. Joseph's Healthcare in Hamilton and the Niagara Health ICU, as well as the Brantford General Hospital ICU, which has enabled both parties to start up and sustain robust clinical trial research programs. And another thing that could help with the experience and getting mentorship support would be developing a national research network to liaise community and academic hospitals, which would encourage community hospitals to participate in clinical trials. So we recognize that there are limitations to the study, in part because there was the rapid turnaround time. So this resulted in a smaller sample size. The survey respondents were self-selected, so they might not be representative of the Canadian community ICU stakeholders as a whole, and they were also weighted more towards Ontario, so there was underrepresentation from other provinces in Canada. However, our next steps and our future directions really aim to address some of these limitations. So since the study was conducted, CERNET's been able to reach out to more community ICU sites outside of Ontario, so from the East Coast, West Coast, including the territories. And we'd like to continue with this research and expand to more of these sites outside of Ontario. So we're creating a follow-up qualitative research study so that we can do a more in-depth inquiry into the factors discussed into this study. And we'll be using the results from the study to guide the interview questions. We'll be conducting focus group interviews as well as in-depth individual interviews. And then in terms of knowledge translation, we received the Canadian Network of COVID-19 Clinical Trials Network grant, and that's aimed to dedicate specific funding to Canadian community ICU sites that are interested in either expanding or implementing research programs in their community ICUs. And so that way we've been able to apply the results from this study already into provision of financial and mentorship support. So thank you so much for your attention, and I'd love to answer any questions that you might have.